Welcome back, everybody, to Funky Distar TV News Time. IPOB unleash war on Fulani herdsmen as plans to force Buhari out of UK heats up. Plans to force Buhari heat up. And the issue of the IPOB and the Fulani herdsmen people in the southeastern part of Nigeria, it don't already clear to everybody now. See now, AK and the army people, they eat the Fulani terrorist herdsmen to kill Biafran people. It don't already clear. Even against some comments when Dave Umahi make after the killing of 18 people in Ebonyi State. Remember, see, you get some other news platforms when tell us say then they more than 18 people when they kill in Ebonyi. Some say 18, some say 15, and some say 25. And remember, see, not be only Ebonyi State the killings happen. It also happened in Enugu State. So Dave Umahi come out in one particular video. They tell them, see, already know some people when they sponsor the Boko Haram people. I mean, yes, the Boko Haram people, because Boko Haram now and that's main people and the bandits, you don't already clear, see, all of them na Boko Haram, because somebody like Garba Shehu don't come out in BBC Hausa. They tell Nigerian people, say the bandit people in particular, that is the kidnappers, people when they kidnap our people, both in the north, both in the south, both in the west, all of them, they work together with Boko Haram people. According to the news, the Garba Shehu will come and talk, say if the kidnappers kidnap finish, the money where they collect as ransom, then they send and go give Boko Haram people to buy weapon. Remember, say not today from Kidi, they tell us, say the herdsmen people, now them we know, say now them be the bandits. If you begin to connect dots to dots, all right, because they don't tell us, say somebody when we say it a rear cow before can't go into banditry, and at the end of the day they make like 100 million or 10 million in a year, why the person will go back to cattle rearing again? The person when expose them before about this issue now, RFI, it make Nigerian people clear, everybody clear, see, if you they sell cow for 1,000 before, for example, and you can't enter bandit, they make 10 million. Waiting will make you go back to cow rearing again. Meaning, say, now the herdsmen people, now they still be the bandits. And we don't see, now Boko Haram people, now then they train the bandit people. And again, yesterday, Nahim Garba Shehu, according to the news, go BBC Hausa, go let Nigerian people know, say the bandits, the ransom money where they collect after kidnapping people, then they carry the money, go give the Boko Haram people to buy weapons. Meaning, say the same herdsmen people, well, don't tell them, say now them be the Boko Haram when they cover face with cows. All Namiyatiala. Now everything don't clear to everyone. Now say everything when they happen in Nigeria, now still the Meyatiala people, now them be the problem of that country. Because Meyatiala cattle breeders, you see that their names, then now still them, now them still be the herdsmen people. And also herdsmen people, now them be the bandit people. The bandit people, when they kidnap finish, they take ransom, they ransom, like that 800 million when they give Gumi, They go carry and go give the Boko Haram people. Even we hear say Gumi still go another meeting with some group of people in the north, but they not allow journalists inside the meeting. That Gumi have to be arrested. We don't call for the arrest of Gumi. The same Nigerian security forces, police and army and DSS, all of them keep mutes. They say nothing happened. Gumi go inside, come out. Go inside, come out. Only him. Now he sabi all the whole banditress when the Nigeria there. The whole kidnappers. So now everything don't clear to us now. See, the bandit people, now them be Boko Haram people. Now them be the same herdsmen people. Now, when did they kill our people? When be the people from Biafran land, the AK, the police, the army, the all of them, the DSS, the SSS, then they tell them, oh yeah, we cannot go ahead. Continue killing them. That is the same ethnic cleansing. And they do the, when they go do the ethnic cleansing, now from the south, southern part of the country and the southeastern part of the country. That is why you see, they don't want to make we leave them alone. They don't want to leave us alone because they want to dominate. They want to take over our lands all over the southeastern part of the country and southwestern part of the country. All this is the happen. Onabuari, they say he did London. Now, somebody like Omukri don't come. Now, him come they talk, see, they must force Buhari out from anywhere when in London. But first of all, before we go to that Omukri own and Onabuhari, we go first of all talk about the IPOB people. Because they don't already make even the Britain, when be the father of all these crimes when they happen in Nigeria. Because then they ate FG, they advise FG on what to do. But I don't see how stupid we African people are. Where would they take order from human beings like us? That is the British people. Because as you see, the black people, they be mumu mumu everywhere. That is why FG still they listen to them. As you see, they no fit to do anything. No, these people, they be fools. So we go continue to use them and take their oil from them forever and ever. Now the thing when British and Nigerian government there, because I know say Nigerian government say all of them when they there, none of them when they are head, they walk from A to Z. Even when they can't even change the Ona Muhammadu Buhari to Jubri, then this, that one alone don't make them know say these African people, all of them, their heads, not they walk. They're not be normal human beings. So we don't know where these African people come from. So we will continue to use them if they don't want to learn lesson. What a shameful thing. What a shameful thing, FG. So ladies and gentlemen, now the same FG people, now then they eat all these things with their so-called security forces. Make we read, make we see how it happened. Wetin IPOB talk and how they take nyan, the nyanis, what the nyan about the murderous herdsmen killing Biafran people in Enugu and Ebonyi states. Not only Enugu and Ebonyi state, ladies and gentlemen. Remember, say no Igbo land or no Biafran land when herdsmen never carry all these their atrocities, even in Delta, name it, every corner. But IPOB, ably led by Mazina Nekano, don't talk say enough is enough. No matter the kind of propaganda when British people will propagate anywhere in the world or when Nigerian people, no matter the kind of propaganda, won't make them stop saving lives and properties in Biafran lands. Now, the IPOB people, they don't wake Oduduwa people up. They don't wake Sunday Igboho up. That is why we don't tell them now when they prepare for 2023. Now, whoa, if you they prepare, you will know how they take prepare. Because that time, you will know whether now get Nigeria or whether the Nigerian people get Nigeria. The indigenous people of Biafra, IPOB, have accused Nigerian security agencies of aiding and abetting murderous henchmen to kill Biafran people of Ebonyi and Enugu states IPOB. While reacting to the alleged killing of henchmen in Enugu and Ebonyi state, through its media and publicity secretary, Emapafo said, they in IPOB and ESN are chasing Fulani henchmen terrorists in the whole southeast and south-southern part of Nigeria, and we will not spare terrorists when they get them. IPOB statement reads in part, it is now clear and open to the public how Nigerian security agencies are aiding and abetting murderous assessment terrorists to kill our Biafran people in Ebonyi and Enugu state. Nigerian security forces are giving them cover to attack the villagers in these two states because Nigerian army and police in uniform are terrorists, Nigerians and Nigeria as a country are suffering today. If Nigerians and communities want to be free from terrorism, they must openly reject Nigeria's security operative in the country. And it is true, ladies and gentlemen, they are all terrorists and working for terrorists. How can security agencies that are supposed to protect and secure innocent citizens will be providing cover for terrorists to attack people? That is what IPOB is talking about. IPOB and ESN are chasing Fulani terrorist henchmen in the whole of southeast and south south, and we won't spare terrorists when we get them. Okay, when I don't hear, now so Emapafo don't talk today. Everybody know who Emapafo be. Now him be the IPOB publicity secretary. And don't tell them, I say, even the police and the army and the DSS, all of them are terrorists and working for terrorists. All of them, they unleash hair on Nigerian innocent citizens. If Boko Haram not kill you inside your one Nigeria, if henchmen not knock you down inside your one Nigeria, your AK, your police, or your DSS will knock you down. That is APC and PDP, because DSS, the AK themselves, won't be the police and the army people. All the whole security forces in Nigeria, all of them, they work for APC and PDP people. So if they knock you, now you see, now still the same APC, now he knock you down. Oh, now when I clench on this one Nigeria, we know say on our come down one day when on our head correct, and very soon all of on our head must correct, because if you not correct, on our get problem in one Nigeria. Make we go see waiting Omukri hashtag again for Ona Buhari when Ona Sinaimbi Ona president when Ron go London. Eh? Remember, see, Gaba Sen Gaba Shehu, when tell Ona see, the ransom when they pay the kidnappers, Naimbi the henchmen people. Eh? See, then they send and go give Boko Haram to buy weapons. Already, it doesn't come at the same man. Don't come see tell Nigerian people. See, the people when they do borrow the change, that is the people when they change money in Nigeria. Eh? Remember, say all of them nasty Fulani people. See, now then see they among people when they sponsor the same Boko Haram. So, every bad thing when they happen in Nigeria, nasty the same Fulani people. Now, then be your problem in that Nigeria. Now that be your problem. Rhino Omukari to stage hashtag harass Buhari out of London protest tomorrow, April 2nd. Former presidential aide Rhino Omukari say he will be staging a protest against President Muhammadu Buhari in UK, that is United Kingdom, where Buhari don't go. Remember, say we never still know the hotel when the Buhari deal. They never see Tokamu because Nigerian people they look for this man wherever he enter. That is not Buhari, oh, ladies and gentlemen. Because not be my own Buhari. No, no Buhari. So they never see know where the man hide enter. In the video shared online, right now, said President Muhammadu Buhari need to be harassed and forced out of UK because he did not acknowledge the Lekki toll gate killing. Rhino added that the president cannot be allowed to go to the UK to seek better health care when he hasn't accounted for killing of ENSA's protesters at the Lekki toll gate. He said, we must harass Buhari out of London and back to Nigeria. October 20, 2020, this man killed peaceful unarmed ENSA's protesters at Lekki toll gate. He didn't care for their life, he just massacred them, but he cares for his own life. After having dashed out debts to young Nigerians who were only asking for good governance for their country, this man now went to come and enjoy the benefit of good governance after he has given debts in Nigeria. He went to come and give life to himself in London. No, we must not allow it. But are they very, very sorry, Rhino Mukari? The man where they talk now, they London already. The very first time when they tell Nigerian people see Buhari they go London. Now Nigeria dead for block the man if una they serious on how una they play on a game. Now Nigeria there, therefore not allow the man leave. Now the man already dey London. Now this one where they talk before say make una not allow it happen before una go begin protest. Like all these killings now when they happen in Nigeria. Then go allow it happen first before they go tell us, say, oh, they don't deploy army, oh, they don't deploy police, oh, they don't deploy this, they don't deploy that. Instead of prevention, you have to prevent it, not to allow it to happen. Not be say, go happen, finish, no, I'm going to find the medicine too for the problem. No, you have to prevent it. And again, I don't know the Buhari, when Rhino or Mukri, they talk about. So the thing don't already happen. The man is in London already. Before you know that, he will stay there 2 weeks and nothing will still happen. The man will still come back. He will still stay inside that Asurok. Because we don't see Nigerian people now only mouth, big mouths like Nigerian people get. If you tell me see this thing will happen in Nigeria about this Buhari, when they cannot make it open to people, if not somewhere like Egypt, or like one of these Arab nations, you think say they go allow it happen? You think say they go allow APC and PDP go scot-free because of this treasonable felony when all of them don't commit in Nigeria? About this same Buhari, when all of us don't know, say don't die, and still some influence, see they come and they call him Buhari. Which Buhari are you talking about? Once again, ladies and gentlemen, if you not get anything one-on-one pertaining this segment, make una come to our comment section, and before you leave, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. One love.